Welcome back, guys, to Farming Chronicles. It's me, Derek Keegan, teaching my fellow farmers about farming. Today we are in a banana plantation, one of my favorites. And before I go forward, I want to say thank you to my colleague, Claire. Hi, Claire. How are you doing? Anyway, today we are talking about the bananas. As you can see here, these are normally called banana fingers. Banana fingers. In this farm, let's walk around. In this farm, we have actually six varieties of bananas. Starting from this line, which were planted 2 years ago. This one is the Sweet Williams. As you can see, these are the Sweet Williams bananas. Claire, you can come and shoot here and see them. These are Sweet William bananas. These are only for ripening. All these are only for ripening. We have another one here also, a different breed. This is called F18. We have F18 for high altitude area, we have F19, and also we have F17 for low altitude area. As you can see also, this one is only for ripening. This one is advisable for eating when it's only ripe. We have the ones that you use for cooking. Another question that most farmers have been asking me is, when do we normally chop off the flower beneath the banana? From my own understanding, once you start producing, the banana starts producing the redundant finger bananas, it's when you measure at least two of your finger size like that and then chop it off. Another thing that most farmers tell me is that, why are my bananas so huge? Well, when they plant the bananas, it is not huge as this one. Key thing, it begins with the right seed. First of all, you have to plant the right seed. It all begins with the right seed. For this one here, we did six variety of bananas here from tissue culture. Hope everyone understands what tissue culture is. It's a process whereby it is a process of micropropagating the seedlings to a sterile environment so that they can withstand diseases, they can produce uniformity and increase productivity. Another thing that most farmers normally struggle with when they are growing their bananas is managing the suckers on the banana plantation. As you can see here, what we normally manage only not more than four bananas, not more than stem bananas. This is because if you maintain more than that, they'll be start fighting for nutrients, they'll fight for water, they'll fight for sunlight, they'll fight even for food. So a majority of farmers who are doing good banana farming should maintain not more than four stems, between three to four stems. These ones will harvest them and transplant them on the other piece of the land up there. Yeah, going back to variety, like I said, this is Sweet Williams. This is F18. We have my favorite here as well. Come Claire, we have to show them. This one is F17, while this one is Grand Main. Those are already four varieties. This is Grand Main, and I think this is going to be the hugest we have ever harvested. This is the most beautiful banana I've ever seen. The hugest we ever harvested is 148 kgs, but I think this is going to surpass that. A kilo of kg in the normal market or international market, they're selling at 18 shillings per kg. So if you have a banana which is above 100 kg, that's basically 1,000 to 2,000 Kenya shillings. Imagine scaling these two up. In an acre, you can plant between 450 to 550 bananas, a single seedling, but they'll produce as well as they'll produce the suckers, you can transfer them to other plants. In an acre, you can basically harvest between 60 to 100 and 10 tons per acre. That's the gestation period of the maturity rate is between 16 to 18 months. These are for this tissue cultured species. Come along, Claire. Ah, someone was asking me the other day, Claire, you remember, Ati, why are we not stocked this one?
Mm-hmm.
Well, this is what I was waiting for. I was waiting for the flower to come along. Maybe something else I've come to learn about these bananas since I've been here for quite some time is that when they start leaning, just know that they are about to produce a banana. Just look at this one, how this one is doing as well. Look at how this one is doing. It started leaning only to produce a fruit. Come on, Claire. When you're planting your banana, this is what I always advise the farmers to do, that they should not cover the whole hole when they're covering, when they're planting the banana. Another thing about planting banana is the measurement for planting a banana. You should do 45 centimeter by 45 centimeter. 45 centimeter width, 45 centimeter length, and the deepness of it is 60 centimeter, roughly 2 meters deep. Use the topsoil that you are, when you're digging for the holes, to mix it with fertilizer. Here we mixed with chicken droppings when we were planting this, And then additionally later we added, on top of it, we added cow droppings. So when you're mixing it, the first mix of the topsoil, you should mix with the fertilizer, organic fertilizer, and then that is the one that you should use to plant your banana with. Then the deeper soil should come on top, and then you should leave it like this. I love these things. These are called, I don't know what they are called, but you used to eat them when you used to be small boys.
The fifi. Mm.
Mm. As you can see, the kind of manure I use, it's cow dung. Cow dung manure. This piece is here is a banana. They're tall, they're huge, they're beautiful. I love farming, I enjoy it. It's my passion. It's where my mission is, my passion. A friend of mine told me that. Anyway, the spacing for bananas, also a very important thing. From one banana seedling to the next banana seedling, it's only 3 meters by 3 meters. From this banana to that one is 3 meters. From this banana to that one is 3 meters by 3 meters. So you can imagine how you can do a lot of things inside the banana farm. You can intercrop it with beans. I especially advise farmers to do green bean, to do nyota beans, being issued by Calro. They are good seeds. They can do well here. You can even do potatoes. You can even do different varieties of sweet potato as well to intercrop them. On top here is what we transplanted, the circuses. Now I call them the second generation, is what we did up here. So Claire can come.
Wow.
And so you need, truly need to control this. There are too many circuses. However, we are using a lot of manure and water as well to make it so that they cannot fight for nutrients. Yeah, so these are the short variety. Most people normally request for this short variety, which is awesome as well. As you can see, we still maintain uniformity of these bananas. Ooh, something is happening here. You see, when we never cut the flower, and the red banana has already matured, so we'll chop that one off. I don't know if any of you want to learn anything about bananas. So far, a recap of what we've discussed. We've discussed about the variety. We said we have Sweet William. We said we have F18, 19, F17. We have Grand Main. We have Matoke, Ugandan Green. And also, we do have Sweet Bananas. For here, we have done six species or six varieties of bananas. Spacing of banana, we said, is from 3 to 3, 3 by 3 by 3 meters. When you're digging a hole, you're supposed to dig 45 by 45 by 60 centimeters going down. And the topsoil is the one you should use to mix with your manure. Bananas take roughly between 16 and 18 months before you harvest, so this is a good plant. A value addition for the banana, as a summary, is that the stems, since they are organic, we can feed this to cows, to livestock, to pigs. Apart from that as well, the flowers, or we can call them the leaves, they used to make cartons. During our pruning season, we call companies, they come and select the ones that they want. And of late, we have people who are doing organic grizzlers with bananas. So yeah, don't have much to say, but I want to thank you for today. Subscribe to our channel, Farming Chronicles. I'm here to learn just as you are, guys. And if you have any questions, just hit me up. Cheers.
Yeah, nice.